Humankind Society, now we will discuss that the equation of a circle and also discuss that what is the standard form equation of a circle and a general form of equation of a circle. But before going this, we must know about that what is a circle. So check out the definition of a circle, that the set of all points in a plane that are equally distant from a fixed point called a circle. So the fixed point in that case is called a center of a circle. As we draw a circle by using this definition, if we have a set of the points in a plane that are equally distant from a fixed point is called a circle, and this point is called a center of this circle. The distance from a center of a circle to any point on the circle is called a radius. For example, if we choose this is a point in a circle, and the distance between the center of the circle and this particular point of on a circle is called a radius. And the full length that a line passing through the center of the circle, which meets the points of the circle, is called a diameter. That is this length. This is a radius, and if we double this length is called a diameter. The whole this length is a diameter. And the distance around a circle is called the circumference of a circle. Suppose if we have a circle and this is a plane. Here is the center of the circle, which of coordinates h and k. And here is a point on a circle, which is x, y. And a distance from the center of the circle to any point of the circle is called a radius of the circle. So to find the equation of the circle, basically we need a formula of a distance between two points. Says that for memorize the distance formula, if we have a point which is posed, a point which is A, which is a coordinate x1, y1, and a point B, which is x2, y2, then what the distance formula says? It says that the distance between these two points as calculated as x2 minus x1 with square. The sign is plus, and then y2 minus y1 with square, and the whole term is in the under root. So basically this is a formula of distance between two points. Is a distance between two points is r, and using this formula x minus h square plus y minus k square, and the whole term is in the under root. So for taking a square on both sides, to get rid of this under root sign, this radical sign, so we have r square, and this is a remaining term. So basically this is called a standard form of equation of a circle with center h and k, and radius is r. So if in the case the center is 0, means hk is 0, as we denote the center with hk and radius is r. So if center is 0, then we can write is r square, which is equals to x square plus y square. Basically this is a equation of a unit circle when the center is 0 and radius is r. Now if we have a center and our radius is given, means if we have our center is minus 3 and 5 and radius, which is equals to 7, we have to calculate the equation of our circle with this given information. So as in the case this is h and this is k, so put the values in the standard form of the equation. So we have x minus h means x minus, and the value of h is minus 3, and taking square, the sign is plus, and y minus, and the value of k is 5, and taking square, which is equals to square of the radius, which is this form. For we compute this factor to simplify, plus y minus 5 square, which is equals to 49. It will be x square plus 9 plus 6x to square plus y square plus 25 minus 10y, which is equals to 49. We basically apply a formula here, which is a square plus b square plus 2ab. X square plus y square plus 6x minus 10y, and to compute all the values, take 49 on the left hand side, then it will be minus 15, which is equals to 0. So we reach an equation, so we will be asked that the equation belongs to which curve, means a circle, parabola or a hyperbola curve. So how can we able to know it? So in order to know that, we have a general form of equation. It says that the x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c, which is equals to 0. As to compare these two equations, this is x square, this is y square, as the 2g is 6 and 2f is minus 10, and where is a constant? Here we can write is g, f and c are all constant. So this is a general form of equation of a circle. So now we have to find a radius and center of this general form of equation. For this, just to compute the factors of which involves x, means x square plus 2gx and separated, plus y square plus 2fy and a constant term to take on the other side, so it will be minus c. Now we make this a complete square. So by a completing square method, what it says that as it is x square, so as we use again our formula a plus b square, which is equals a square plus b square plus 2ab. So here is x square and 2, and x is given. So what the value that we require to complete this factor, which is a g. So add the square of this factor and subtract this factor as well. So basically this is our completing square method, and the factor which is plus, now complete square with this factor, so it will be y square plus 2fy plus f square, and similarly to subtract this term for balance this equation, which is equals to minus. As you see that this factor and this factor makes a complete square as x plus g square, and take this minus g square on the other side, so it will be plus g square, and these three factors make a square, which is y plus f square, and make this negative f square on the other side, so it will be positive f square. Now to compute this, we also write these factors as we can write minus minus g square plus y minus minus f with term of square, as minus minus is plus, and after this we reach again this step, so which is equals to minus c plus g square plus f square. So compare this equation with a standard form of the equation, which is x minus h square plus y minus k square, which is equals to r square. If we suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, then to compare first and second equation, so we have to compute that what is the center and what is the radius of a general form of equation, as the radius is minus g minus f, and the radius, as to compare these two equations, r square, which is equals to minus c plus g square plus f square, but we have to compute or get rid of a square. So if we take square root on both sides, so we are left with plus g square plus f square under root, means which is minus g minus c plus g square plus f square with under. So here is our equation of the form of our general form of equation. Then we have to compute our center and the radius of this equation. First of all, the general form of equation is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c, which is equals to 0. So here we compute it. Here you see that the x square and y square, the coefficient is 1. So make this factor as divide this whole equation with 5. So we are left, if we suppose this is first equation, so divide first equation with 5. So we are left with x square plus y square plus 24 over 5x plus 36 over 5y plus 10 over 5, which is equals to 2, which is equals to 0. Now to compare these two equations and to compute the value of a factor g and a factor of f. So x square plus y square. So in the formula, the value of 2 and here is x. So we find the value of a term which will give this factor. If we write 12 over 5, so then if we multiply, we back this factor. Plus the 2 is in the formula and y. So we have to compute the value of f by using this. So if we write 18 over 5 plus 2, which is equals to 0. The value of g, which is equals to 12 over 5, and the value of f, which is 18 over 5, and the value of c, which is equals to 2. We know about what is the center and what is the radius as we discuss here. Center, which is equals to minus g and minus f. So the center of this equation is minus 12 over 5 and minus 18 over 5. Now we have to compute our radius, which is equals to the value of c is 2, so it will be minus 2 plus g square, which will be square of this term, so it will be 144 over 25. The sign is plus and the square of the factor f, which is 324 over 25, and the whole term is in under root. So after solving this, it will be 814 under root and divided by 25, which is equals to 418 under root over 5. So it will be the radius. So this is all about today's lecture. If you like this, then don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share.